Kia ora, good evening. Queues for COVID tests in Northland have continued for a second day, but health officials are feeling more encouraged with no new community cases. 15 close contacts of the Northland case have now received negative tests, with just one more awaiting their results. Extra staff have been sent to the region's testing stations following long lines at community centres, with more than 1,500 tests processed yesterday. And more good news today, confirmation New Zealand's first COVID-19 vaccine could be approved by MedSafe as early as next week. And this means we'll be able to take delivery of the Pfizer vaccine as soon as it's ready to be sent. We're live to Whangarei and Parliament shortly. First though, here's our Northland-based reporter Helen Castles.
Getting in early. Those caught in long lines yesterday hoping to get the jump on the queues today.
We had to wait. It was a shocking. It was just lines after lines. We had the police controlling it.
Testing reinforcements called in. 5 clinical staff from Auckland helping clear the backlog at Ruakaka.
Things are moving faster. Beautiful water and peaches. Thanks, guys.
We've got heaps of food, heaps of water, got the wiggles.
Queue stretching down the Ruakaka racetrack driveway. The COVID positive woman visiting several stores in this small town just south of Whangarei. Local iwi on site to provide some relief.
We were fielding reports from our people of long waits, and our aroha goes out to those manning the sites.
At Poe Island in central Whangarei, wait times down dramatically on yesterday. Lines shorter at Carmel too.
We were told by Health One to come down and get a test.
1,776 tests completed yesterday, none returning a positive result.
I want to remind people, if you are not a close contact, a casual or a casual plus contact, and you're not showing symptoms, please don't line up for testing.
The scare putting added pressure on an already struggling health system.
But we're now getting inquiries, numerous inquiries every day now from patients who are concerned about minor coughs and colds and sniffles, that it may be COVID, they want screening. But the thing here in Northland is we're very, very short of GPs, so we're certainly under the pump with this.
Doctors sending those who want tests elsewhere.
We certainly do COVID tests on people who are unwell, but we're not for screening patients. That's what the CBACs are for.
Those running the swabbing centres hoping the bulk of the tests are now behind them.
And Helen's with us now live from Whangarei. Helen, just how significant was the demand on those carrying out the testing yesterday?
Kia ora. Well, as you heard in my story, more than 1,700 Northlanders were tested yesterday. That's the equivalent to 1% of Northland's entire population being tested in a single day. And that number will, of course, increase as more swabs are registered. But regardless, that number is unprecedented in terms of a New Zealand record-breaking context. And just to put that into perspective, at the height of the outbreak in August, in a single day in Auckland, only 8.80% of its population was tested.
And something we saw in previous lockdowns, talk of the iwi-led border checkpoints being reinstated.
Yes, well, I spoke to a spokesperson from the Te Tai Tokerau Border Control Group earlier, and they said they want all Waitangi celebrations in the north to be cancelled. They just don't want any visitors coming into the region, and that includes the likes of the Prime Minister. So from Thursday, they will set up a checkpoint in Waiomio, which is just north of Whangarei, to try and encourage people to turn around. And while they don't have the legal authority to do so, they just hope that people will understand and respect their wishes.
Ngā mihi, Helen in Whangarei, Helen Castles.